You've probably been associated with and friend to more of the great stars than any other performer alive.
Yeah, I was not only the stars. I would say that in my time, I knew Queen of England, Churchill, Somerset Maugham, Charles de Gaulle, presidents from Wilson on. Only one that I never met was General Eisenhower. But all the rest I had an association with.
In going through the books that you've written, I went through them again because I hadn't read some of them in a long time. I went through the friar's dinner that they gave you on the coast.
What book is that? Which book is that?
This Way Miss.
Oh, yes, yes.
And some of the line, George Burns' speech on you about meeting the different girls and he wasn't able to talk. Some of the most brilliantly comic lines that I can't wait for the opportunity, frankly, to get to talk to George Burns and Jack Benny and these other
people. Well, I'll see
that
you do.
Well, that's very kind of you.
Jack Benny. At that dinner, I think that's where Jolson got up.
Yes.
And he said, folks, I'll sing all night. And I said, no, you won't. This is my dinner. You'll sit down.
Right.
I was the only one that had any authority with Jolson the last 4 or 5 years. I could walk on the stage and he was out. He wouldn't let anybody near him but me. That only in the last 4 or 5 years.
Up till then, was it a question of just this incredible ego compared to insecurity?
I guess it was that, too. I'd rather, it's kinder to say it was a continuous insecurity regardless how great he was doing.
The balance of nature, of life, that one can be given such greatness and ego on one hand,
and
to balance it out.
I think you're exactly right about that. That's a good thought, too. And it's kinder to say it was his continuous insecurity more than his ego that made him act as he did. I'll remember that.
Well, thank you very, very much for talking with me. I think I've covered almost all of the things that I wanted.
Well, you're about the most sensitive young fellow that I've met to come around this business in a long time.
Right,
if there's any justice in the world, or if there's anything left of the amusement business, I'm sure you're going to get somewhere.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
And anybody who can think and talk as sensitively as you do, you may be able to write, too.
I am writing.
Well, there you are. That's the thing. Everything dies except the written word. The written word is the only thing that lives. And men that have been long since gone for 3,000 years keep their impact upon life because of what they have said on paper.
The very basis behind the thinking of this book is to, for all time, to have what I have asked you and the answers that you've given compiled in a book among all of the great funny men who are living today, so that 30 years from now, some young fella somewhere could pick up this book and see what George Jessel had to say when I asked him.
What are you going to call the book?
Comedians Talk About Comedy.
Well, give that a little thought. That sounds a little light for the kind of book that you're planning. Because you'll find in nearly all of the interviews among the fellows that I know, like Benny and Burns and Skelton and Hope, you'll get some laughs, but you'll get a great deal of serious thought as well. Now, that title may be a little bit too light for the kind of book that you... this is not right, but what the comedians think, or that kind of a thing.
Yes.
Then you give it a little, you paint it on a broader canvas.
Yeah.
You know?
Right. The point is that no one, to my knowledge, as you probably know, I have, you see my collection on your books, I have a library I'm terribly proud of about my profession. I've got almost all of the books.
This might be a title, excuse me.
Surely.
The Private Thoughts of Funny Men. You know, guys, for example, who are such fools on the stage, like And Ed Wynn was a great, great buffoon comedian. And he had a very serious man.
I have a 45-minute interview with him.
That's good. We'll fool around with the title. I'll try, Sam and I'll try to think of a title, too.